alphabet, there's no way someone can change the order.
It's impossible.
That's what I'm saying. So I refuted you. Now let's go to Quran. Quran is impossible for someone to change it. Muslim children, the age of 8 and 9, their mom was the Quran word for word, the letter for letter. And not about 5 or 10.
I know what you're getting at now. Because yeah, the Bible's been rewritten 1,000 times, and the last time it was rewritten was in English.
No, the point here is the Bible wouldn't even have in its pure language.
But the Quran's never been rewritten.
No, the point here is also the Bible wouldn't even have it in its pure language. Jesus was not from Brixton.
No.
Jesus was from Palestine. Jesus never spoke French or English. Jesus spoke Aramaic. That language would not have it. So we don't know what Jesus said. In the reality,
but the Bible's
Quran. Big time.
Okay.
Big sign.
Oh.
You see, that's why you need the Quran. That's why. Forget about the camera.
The Bible's Quran.
Yeah.
No, I do believe that the Bible is Quran.
Alhamdulillah.
But I don't believe that the Bible is wrong. I think that it's corrupt.
So what is the difference between corrupt and wrong?
Because I also believe that 9 out of 10 religions follow the exact same story, just from a different standpoint.
No,
so
but
I'm not saying that it's wrong, but I do think that
no,
it's
No, what I'm asking, what is the difference between corrupt and wrong?
Because, okay, so corrupt means that it has a point to it. A corrupt,
has mistakes.
The Bible itself is supposed to be that of a positive nature.
Say it again, sorry.
It's supposed to be that of a positive nature. The problem is the corrupt side of it is, like you said, it has been rewritten a ridiculous amount of times. The last edition of it was in English. Therefore, we have got the Chinese whispers of the last edition, which is why I think that's the corruptness. I'm not saying that the original Bible is wrong, but I don't get what it's saying now. Because
no,
it's too contradictory.
Corrupted
means it contradicts itself.
Corrupted, yeah, and that cannot be from the Almighty.
No,
because
exactly.
One of the criteria Allah to show mankind that the Quran, from him, that you will not find no contradiction in the Quran. Because the one that does not contradict himself is the Almighty. You understand?
So if I was to read the Quran, I wouldn't find no contradiction.
Never contradiction in the Quran. That's a challenge.
I'll read, but yeah.
Yeah, I will give you the Quran.
No, my daughter's got one in her bag, but there's no corruption.
No, you know what? That's what Allah challenged people. Allah said in the Quran, if this book was from other than Allah, if this book was from other than Allah, you will find a lot of contradictions. Allah challenged mankind to find any contradictions. And that's why one of the miracles of the Quran, that now we can verify and we can the claim, you know, there's a claim in the Quran that the Quran will be preserved. Now, if the Jews and the Christians and the Muslims burn their scriptures, the only scripture will remain with us is the Quran. Do you know who can bring it back into written form? Not the Muslim scholars, the Muslim children can do that. As for the Christians and the Jews, they have even memorized one chapter in that scripture.
What?
Not one gospel, one chapter.
Yeah, which one?
Have you memorized chapter from where? John? John, tell me what John 5:2 says.
John 3:16.
I ask you 5:2. You Christian scholars have no more words of the Bible. I'm asking you what John 5:2 said.
You're asking it. Do you know how many Christians got married and asked them instead? Like, stop.
I bring any Christians here, they have no more as one page.
No, all I'm saying is
we Muslims.
This part right here is what Nation of Islam does.
Who is Nation of Islam?
Nation of Islam, they've memorized parts of the Quran and they shout it at people in the
street. No, Nation of Islam, they're not Muslims. Nation of Islam is like Hebrew Israelite. It's a reaction of racism. In Harlem and in New York, especially New York, what happened when some black people want to fight back racism, they start utilizing Bible and some start utilizing the Quran. Nation of Islam are racist. They believe the white man is a devil. That's not the teaching of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A devil can be white, black, Arab, non-Arab. It's not about your skin color. That's why in the Quran says, "Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum." The most righteous person with Allah, not the black man, not the white man, not the Arab. No, the one who has piety and righteousness. And the Prophet Muhammad said, "There's no difference between a black and a non-black, between an Arab and non-Arab, except with piety and righteousness." That's why Prophet Muhammad's uncle is going to the hellfire. And Bilal from Abyssinia, he was a slave, he's going to go to paradise. To show you that Islam, go and get the teaching of a nation of Islam, those people, you understand? So Islam is not about skin color.
I need to read that book. Here.
As a gift for you.
I need to read that book. No, the reason why I say that is because the Bible has a lot about slavery and a lot about culture. And
let me tell you about slavery. In Islam, let me tell you about slavery. You know what happened before transatlantic slavery? Everyone was enslaving everyone. It's known. You know, Egyptians, Hebrew, Israel.
Yeah,
Islam comes in there is slavery already, servitude. I don't like to use the term slavery because automatically people think what?
Transatlantic.
So servitude. And Islam comes in and there is a servitude. Islam, the only time when servitude is allowed in Islam in a time of war. But as for going around kidnapping people, Prophet Muhammad said, anyone that goes around kidnap people and make them as a slave, then Allah will be his opponent on the Day of Judgment. In another narration, Prophet Muhammad ﷺ said, anyone that goes around and enslave black people or white people, Arab, any person, take them as slave, kidnap them, then his prayer will not be accepted. That's why if the Europeans follow the Islamic teaching, they would have gone to Africa and enslaved black people. But when they utilize the Bible, that's why the first boat that departed from Africa to America was what? In the name of Jesus. The Bible was utilized to enslave the black people, you understand? That's why when they came to Africa, say, close your eyes and pray, and they took the lens. The French had to do it to us. But anyway, I don't want to give you too much information. Let's go back to the main point. You already believe in one God, you understand? But you need to worship God according to his teaching. And that is in Islam.
Well, I know about Mustafa, I know about Christianity. So
read it. Look after yourself. Take care, yes? Where are you going for the haka?
They're ready for me, you know? I believe in Jesus is one. Jesus and God is God.
Jesus cannot be God.
No, I know what Jesus is God.
Let me ask, is Jesus God?
Jesus is the God.
What is he? Prophet of God. So you come into Islam closer, mashallah.
Yeah.
So now, can you trust the Bible?
Yeah.
Can you trust the Bible?
Right, I know my brain may get old, so I can't store much thing in my brain.
You have to translate sometimes, Jamal. No, you Jamaican, it's my people.
No,
ask you, can you trust the writers of the Testament? Can you trust them?
What do you mean by that?
Okay, do you know who wrote the manuscripts that the King James based upon?
No, I know that, you have the Bible cancer two book, yeah?
No,
let me say something to you. You cancer the Old Testament and the New Testament.
I'm not asking about that. I'm asking you simply, uncle, the New Testament.
Matthew, Mark, John, and them.
No, wait a minute. King James is based upon the manuscript.
Yeah.
That manuscript came literally 700 years later after Jesus. We don't know who wrote it. We just found it, discovered it, dusted it out, and we start blind following it. As a Muslim, we ask questions. Who wrote it? Were they trustworthy? Were they truthful? Doesn't mean because something is ancient, we have to follow it. So my point here is,
now hear me out. Get men inspired to write things.
No, hear me out. Do you know their names? Those who wrote the manuscripts?
No, I don't really know their names, but you know
their. Are they trustworthy if you don't know their names? Are they trustworthy?
Nobody, you can't trust nobody.
Khalas, so why are you following the book? So why are you following the Bible?
Eh?
Why are you following the book to worship the Creator, the Most High?
No, them Jesus died to return.
Again, uncle, the information you got it from a book, you don't know who wrote it.
No, but I have to inspire man.
Father, brother, go ahead.
Just nice.
No problem.
Sorry.
My name is Byron.
Nice to meet you, Byron. My name is Shamsi.
Cool. But can you trust me?
I don't know you. I can't trust you.
All right. So there you go. So how is that argument?
That's true.
Just nice.
For you to understand, yeah. So my point here is, I'm speaking to the uncle here.
Yeah.
I said to him, look, King James is based upon a manuscript.
Yeah.
That manuscript was discovered literally 100 years after.
Okay.
Literally, the Christian scholars say to you, that manuscript is a copy of 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 the original one.
Okay.
Yeah? Or more than that. So I'm asking him, if you don't know the writers, can we trust him? He said, no. I said, so how can you worship God on a book you don't know who wrote it? That's my point. As for the Muslim who come to the other side, we know the Quran. The Quran was not passed down to us by a book that we discovered in Saudi 700 years after Prophet Muhammad. No, the Quran was passed down to us generation after generation. Since memorization, yeah. So the time Prophet Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasalam, he used to receive the revelation, read it out to his companions, they read it out to him.